Learn about SwiftUI's brand new NavigationStack API for iOS 16 and how you can adopt it in your projects today. Hey Code Crew, this is Flo. This lesson introduces the new NavigationStack, NavigationPath, and NavigationDestination APIs from iOS 16 to you. As of the date of this recording, iOS 16 is still in beta, so you will have to use the Xcode 14 beta version as well. You can download that Xcode version from the Apple developer website, which is linked down below. First of all, I have prepared an empty Xcode project here, and note that I am using the Xcode 14 beta, beta 2 in this case, but it should probably work the same in the upcoming beta versions as well. So first of all, let's have a look at how a navigation stack would have been implemented before iOS 16. So we would probably have a navigation view like that. And then in the content, we would have a navigation link with a title and a destination. So as a title, let's say simple string, and let's expand the destination to be a trailing closure. And in here, we would then just have a view that should be navigated to. So let's just say ABC here, just to test it out. So now if we click on the simple string, it will navigate to a new view that's just a text of ABC. So super simple stuff, actually. Now let's embed that navigation view, or let's actually embed the navigation link in a list. Super simple like that. So we just have a little bit of styling here as well. So this is how it used to be. You had a navigation link with a title, which could also be a view, of course, and then a destination that's obviously also a SwiftUI view. Now in iOS 16, a bunch of these things have changed. So first of all, navigation view is getting deprecated. Instead, you will use the navigation stack if you want the same behavior. And also the navigation links have actually changed quite a bit. So let's first of all remove the navigation view and replace it with a navigation stack. By itself, this still behaves exactly the same. So in iOS or on iPhones, actually, navigation view is directly translated to navigation stack. Both of these are equivalent. Now, of course, if you want a multi-column layout, you will not be able to use navigation stack, but that's for another lesson later on. Okay, so you can just replace your old navigation view with a navigation stack and nothing will change. You can still use the old navigation link as well. Next, let's try out the new navigation link API, and we will also need a new view modifier to make that work. So let's comment out the old navigation link and let's create a new one. And if we scroll down a bit here, let's see. Okay, it's actually not showing. Here it is. So the new navigation link takes in a title, once again, a string. This could also be a view, of course, if you want to do that approach. So let's say simple string once again. So the exact same title as beforehand. But now instead of providing a destination view, now you just provide a value. So let's try that out. Let's provide a value of ABC. What will happen if we click on the navigation link now? Exactly, nothing will happen because SwiftUI doesn't know where to navigate. It just knows the label is simple string and the value is ABC, but it has no idea about what to do with that value. And that's what we need to teach SwiftUI with the new navigation destination view modifier. You can create multiple of these modifiers and we will look into that in a bit. But for now, you will always have to specify a type. In our case, the value was a string, right? So we will say string.self, and then we will get in our string here, and then we can return a view. So for example, now we can just create a text with that string again, and then we will have the exact same behavior as beforehand. So now if we click on the simple string navigation link, we will go to a new view in our navigation stack, of course, which displays a text with the value that we passed. And the value that we passed was ABC. Of course, now we could style this and say foreground color of red. And now if we click, it will of course be red. So super simple stuff. But now instead of having to add the destination to the navigation link directly and then thus have it in multiple places in one view, for example. Now you just have to add one navigation destination modifier to some content of your navigation stack, so not on the navigation stack itself, somewhere inside of it. And then that will let SwiftUI's new navigation system know what to display, so this text with the foreground color, for which type of value, so in this case, for the string type. Now, a very notable thing here is that these types all need to be hashable. String is already hashable, just as integers, for example, but if you have custom types, which we will look at next, or in a bit, actually, then you need to pay attention. Your types need to conform to the hashable protocol. So next, let's have a look at something that got actually way better with iOS 16, and that's programmatic navigation. If we remove this comment here, because we don't need it anymore, and we get rid of the navigation stack for a second and just type in navigation stack, you will see that there are a bunch of different initializers. There is one with just a root view, which is what we previously used. This trailing closure here is basically the root view. And then there's also one where you pass in a path. And this is where it gets very interesting. So for the path, we can just create a array. So let's say path, and this is an empty array of type string, because we're just dealing with strings. And now we can just bind to that path here in our navigation stack. And now we can run the preview again, and you will see that it works exactly the same. The cool thing now is, though, that we can play around with this path. And since it's just an array, we can add values or remove values programmatically. So let's get back into our list and let's add a button and let's say navigate to XYZ. And you will see we have a new button here. And right now, if we click on it, obviously nothing happens because the action closure is empty. But now in this action, we could just say path.append XYZ, so add the string XYZ to this array of strings. And now if we click the button, we will actually navigate to our destination that we specified below. So a red text of the value, and the value in this case is just XYZ. So this is how programmatic navigation works. Of course, you could factor all of this out into a view model and then have a very nice architecture. It also works the other way around though. So if we go into our destination and embed this text in a VStack, then below it, we could add a button, say pop to root. And in here, we can just set our path.removeAll. This way, we will remove all strings from our array of navigation paths. And consequently, that will mean that there is nothing left to navigate to. So SwiftUI will pop to root. So let's try it out. Let's click on the simple string. This will navigate us with the value ABC. And now if we say pop to root, it will pop to root. This obviously also works multiple levels deep. So now if we grab our button and also put it inside of the navigation destination, we can click on simple string. We're at ABC right now. Then let's navigate to XYZ. So we're at XYZ now. And the array would right now be ABC in the first slot and XYZ in the second slot. So if we hit back, we're back to ABC, of course, because that's where we came from. But now if we say pop to root, the array gets emptied. So this is a super simple way to programmatically navigate now in SwiftUI. Very nice, I would say. And then lastly, let's have a look at a more practical application of this, where we have multiple different types for our navigation path. For that, I have prepared two different structs. First of all, the article struct with a bunch of examples, and the person struct also with a bunch of examples. So let's go back to content view and let's remove everything basically that we already had. So let's get rid of the path and let's get rid of the navigation stack and let's basically just start blank. So let us create a new navigation stack with a path and a root view. Now for the path, instead of using an array of string, for example, there is a brand new type. So let's call this variable path. And let's say this is a navigation path. This is basically a generic implementation of the array where we can push multiple different types into it. And you will see what that means in just a second. So just create a state variable called path that is a navigation path. And now we can bind to that in our navigation stack, just as we did before with our array of strings. Okay, now in here, let's add a list back. And in this list, let's add one section called people. And in this section, let's iterate over all of the person examples. So let's say person.examples, person in. Now, one thing to note here is that both person and article conform to identifiables, so we can use for each without specifying an ID property. And they also conform to hashable, which is why we can then use it with the navigation path API. So right now there is obviously nothing on the screen except for the section title or the section header people. So let's have a look at which values a person has. So it has a name and an age. So maybe let's add just a little VStack here with a text of person.name and then a text of person.age. And let's format that as a number. Okay, and let's also say the alignment is leading and the age has a foreground color of secondary, so it's grayed out a bit. Okay, so that looks pretty good, I would say. Right now, this is just a VStack though, so let's maybe copy that VStack and instead create a navigation link with a value and a label. As the label, let's paste back the VStack. The value now becomes the person object because we want to navigate to a detail view of that person, for example. You can see that in the list now it turned into a navigation link with a little chevron on the trailing edge. But of course, clicking on the navigation links doesn't do anything because SwiftUI doesn't know about the destination. It only knows about the value, which is a person object. So let's teach SwiftUI about the destination. Let's select your list and add to it the navigation destination modifier. Of course, we now want to set the destination for the person type. We will get a person in here. And in this example, it will just be a very simple text of the person.name, and we might give it like a font of headline. That should work, I think. Okay, so now let's click on Steve here and it will navigate to a new view saying his name, which is Steve, of course. Okay, so that was simple enough and basically the same thing as we had beforehand. But now let's add a second section and let's call it articles. And in here, you guessed it, we will add some different articles. So let's say for each article.examples. Article in. So this is now our second section. And of course, we will add some new navigation links as well. As the value, we will pass the article, same as beforehand. And as the label, let's have a look at which variables this has. So it has a title and an author. So we can probably just do pretty much the same layout as beforehand. So let's add a VStack with an alignment of leading. And let's add a text saying the article.title, maybe with a font of headline, and then another text of the article.author with a font of subheadline. Okay, so that looks good, I would say. Now that we have both sections, we can still click on the people section, of course, and it will navigate. But we can't click on the articles section yet because we only taught SwiftUI a navigation destination for the person type. So let's add a second navigation destination for the article type. Now in here, we will of course get an article in. And once again, for the sake of this lesson, let's just keep it simple and say article.title. And now if we click on an article, it will navigate correctly. And if we click on a person, it will also navigate correctly. Now we can again get a little bit more crazy and embed one of these destinations in a VStack and add a button for pop to root. And in here, we can say path.removeLast, and we will add a number here, and this will be path.count. So basically, this means remove all of the items from the current navigation path. Let's try this out. So if we click on Steve, we just see their name. And if we click on Combine Mastery, for example, we have the pop to root button, which will pop to root. Let's add a second button to maybe append another article or a person. So let's add another button. Let's say navigate to person. And then we can say path.append. Any hashable value is what we can append here now. And in our case, let's just say person.examples, and we'll just use the second one, I guess. That should work just fine. So now if we click on an article, then we can say navigate to person. And now we're at Maria because that's the second person that we had. And of course, pop to root also still works. So let me briefly go over everything that you just learned in this lesson. You learned that the old navigation view on iPhone got replaced with a navigation stack, and that the old navigation link got replaced with a new navigation link, where instead of specifying the destination, you just specify any hashable value that's passed into the navigation. Then, to do something with that value and to actually display a destination, you add the NavigationDestination modifier to any of your views inside of the navigation stack. For this modifier, you have to specify a type that you want this to work for. Then you get an instance of that type, and you can just add your destination view in here. Of course, this could also be a custom view. Next, if you want to implement programmatic navigation, you will have to create a navigation path and bind to that path in your navigation stack view. And lastly, to programmatically navigate to any new value, you can just say path.append and then your hashable type in the brackets. And if you want to pop to root, you can just remove all values from your navigation path. So in this lesson, you learned about how SwiftUI navigation is handled in iOS 16 and hopefully also later on. You found out about navigation stack, navigation path, navigation destination, and the new way to use the navigation link. You also learned about programmatic navigation without explicit navigation links and just buttons.